Hello world, Sean Grooms here again with Free Code Camp, and in this video, I'll be explaining what sets are. A set is a collection of distinct objects called elements or members. An element is essentially anything you want it to be, and for example, elements could be numbers, letters, variables, more sets, or nothing at all. Sets are usually denoted by capital letters, such as capital A, capital B, C, E, or F, and we say that the set contains elements. For example, we could say that the set A equals the set containing the element 5. Or we can say that 5 is an element of A. Now, I will be introducing a lot of symbols like this. This just means is an element of, and it'll save us a lot of time in future videos. And I don't have to write out is an element of each time, so that'll come in handy. So what does a set actually look like? Well, there are two common types of notation for sets, and the one I'm introducing in this video is roster notation, and it looks like this. It's just curly braces with elements inside separated by commas, which is very similar to JavaScript. The only difference being that in math we use curly braces, and in JavaScript we use a square bracket. So now let's just walk through these. So the set A equals the set containing the element 5. That's how you would read this. The set B equals the set containing elements 2, 3, and 4. The set C equals the set containing elements D, F, and G. Now, D, F, and G, they don't have to be variables. They're either variables or they could be characters. It just depends on the context. The set E, it contains no elements in this case, which has an impact that you'll see in future videos. And finally, the set F equals the set containing elements A, B, and C. In this case, our elements are sets, so we would read this as F equals the set containing the element 5, the set containing elements 2, 3, and 4, and the set containing D, F, and G. So in the next video, I'll be going over a different form of set notation, in addition to introducing you to some common sets. And this will set us up, eventually my goal is to bring us up to being able to define and understand algorithms. And this is where we have to begin.